Is there a storm brewing in the Sussex household? That's the million-dollar question these days. Diving right in, the rumor mill is churning full speed with whispers about Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's marriage hitting rocky waters. You've probably heard the buzz too, right? Well, it's hard to pin down the truth, but the clues? They're piling up. Take this recent scoop from OK Magazine, for example. They're saying Harry is on the lookout for a new pad in the UK. Remember how we talked about them getting the nudge to leave Frogmore Cottage? Yeah, King Charles apparently decided not to renew their lease post spare release. Not exactly an eviction, but the message was pretty clear: find somewhere else. So, here's where it gets interesting. Meghan and Harry, as of now, don't have a UK base. Sure, Harry's been told he can crash at a palace room, but he's got to give a heads up, which he doesn't seem too keen on. Okay. Magazine spills that Harry's actually house hunting, even though Meghan might not be all in on the idea. Word on the street is they might start looking for their own spot near London, despite some disagreements. But let's not jump the gun and assume everything's doom and gloom. These two have been through a lot, and who knows? Maybe they're just figuring things out, like any other couple. What's clear is that the Sussex narrative is far from simple, and with every new report, the plot only thickens. Keep an eye out, because this story is far from over, and who knows what twist awaits around the. In the latest twist of the Sussex saga, it looks like Prince Harry is taking the reins in a potential move back to the UK. It's no shocker, really. Why would Meghan be eager to get closer to the in-laws, especially after all the drama? It's Harry who seems keen on reconnecting with his roots. According to the Grapevine, or rather OK Magazine, Harry's got this idea of Archificial and Invisibet soaking up their British heritage. The kids might be a bit too young to grasp all that, but hey, who am I to judge? The buzz is that they might even use a small apartment in Kensington Palace occasionally. But the real deal? They're apparently looking to buy their own place. This shift hints at Harry spending more time in the UK. But where does that leave Meghan? Well, if we're going by what Tina Brown dished out, Meghan might not be too thrilled. Tina, in a Sky News Australia interview, mentioned that Meghan feels rejected by England and prefers the glitz of Hollywood. Talk about a crossroads, right? Meanwhile, there's all this chatter about Meghan's career moves, possible meetups with Tyler Perry in Atlanta, and whatnot. On the flip side, Harry seems content when he's in the UK. So, we're looking at a couple potentially heading in different directions. Harry, drawn to his homeland, and Meghan, maybe not so much. It's a fascinating time for the Sussexes, with every new development adding another layer to their unfolding story. As we keep an eye on their next steps, one thing's certain: this tale is far from its final chapter, and the next twist could be just around the. Let's dive deeper into the narrative around Meghan and Harry. Remember, these articles we're reading aren't just random musings. They're crafted stories, not exactly the epitome of unbiased journalism. What if this is all a strategic setup? Think about it, a narrative leading us gently towards an inevitable split due to irreconcilable differences. It's like they're prepping us for a smooth landing when the divorce news hits. The idea? To paint a picture of two lovebirds tragically parting ways because, well, life happened. Amidst this, there's a new twist. Prince Harry's house hunting in London is making waves. But alongside that, there are headlines suggesting a different angle. For instance, The Express ran a piece titled "Prince Harry Trying to Avoid Being Overshadowed by Meghan Markle." April Glover from The Express interprets this as Harry's attempt to distance himself from Meghan, focusing on his own ventures without the Meghan distraction. And then there's The Mirror, bringing in body language expert Darren Stanton to dissect their dynamics. His observation? A stark contrast from their earlier days of public affection. He comments on their recent photos, noting the lack of intimate gestures that once defined their appearances. It's a subtle yet telling shift, according to him. The narrative here is complex, layering personal aspirations with public perceptions. As Harry seeks a foothold in London and Meghan possibly remains anchored in her Hollywood preferences, the speculation intensifies. Are they crafting a public image of two paths diverging? As we observe these developments, the unfolding story of Meghan and Harry continues to captivate and perplex, leading us to wonder what turn their journey will take next, and how this chapter will eventually. the plot thickens in the ongoing saga of Meghan and Harry. Let's dissect this a bit, shall we? Observers are noticing a shift in their body language, and it's causing quite the stir. There's talk about a recent photo where they're almost holding hands, but not quite. It's got people talking. Is this a sign of trouble in paradise? Darren Stanton, a noted body language expert, chimed in with his take. He's not entirely on board with the idea that they're starting to despise each other. His perspective? They're not as mutually supportive as they once appeared. Take Harry's solo appearance at the Well Child Awards, for instance. And then there's Meghan's last-minute decision to attend Invictus, which some speculate was more for PR than anything else. The couple has had a rough time lately. This summer was far from smooth sailing for them. When things get tough, it seems they're not great at introspection. Instead of looking inward, there's a pattern of externalizing their problems, laying blame elsewhere. But now, they're far removed from Harry's family, and that narrative of them against the world is losing its grip. So, what happens when you can't blame the outside world anymore? Well, it looks like they might be turning on each other, pointing fingers for their setbacks. No one's admitting any fault. For the first few years, they could point to external factors, Harry's family, the media, you name it. They had each other's back against the world. But now, with the distance from the royal family and the lack of recent contact, that narrative isn't holding up. They're left to face their issues head-on, and without the us-against-them storyline, it's a whole new ballgame. As we watch this unfold, it's clear that the dynamics of their relationship are shifting, taking us into uncharted territory, and leaving us wondering what will happen next as they navigate this new phase of their. In the latest chapter of Meghan and Harry's story, there's a sense that they're losing their grip on the narrative. Despite their PR team's best efforts with daily positive spins, their popularity isn't skyrocketing as they might have hoped. It's an uphill battle for them, and the results aren't quite aligning with their aspirations. A subtle yet telling sign of change was recently noted. Meghan, who once frequently referred to Harry endearingly as "my husband," has shifted her language. Now, "he's just this one." This change in tone has raised eyebrows and fueled speculation. Are they still sharing the same space, or has distance crept in? Rumors are swirling about them living apart, with Harry possibly resorting to hotel stays. It's a situation that keeps evolving, and each new piece of information adds another layer of intrigue. The dynamics of their relationship, their public image, and their future plans are all subjects of intense scrutiny. As the story continues to unfold, it remains to be seen how Meghan and Harry will navigate these choppy waters, and what the next development in their saga will be as they